That's what they do, y'all. Amen. We honor them today as well. And at this point, we're grateful to God that He has them stationed in a place where they can stop by to visit with us every now and then. Years ago, 911, early in the morning, you heard Georgia allude to it during the praise and worship time. We were flying home from London, England, when all of a sudden the captain of the plane came across and he said, "Folks, for some reason or another, we will not be able to land this plane on American soil." And having the humorous attitude that I have, I said, "He need to stop playing." And we 35,000 feet in the air. And then he came back again and he said something. I said, "Well, maybe not playing." Of course, we in the air, we didn't know what was going on. And he didn't either. And finally, about 30, 40 minutes later, he shared with us that there was something going on in America. Well, I'm thinking maybe an earthquake. Once we landed, allow me to share this part of the story. Once we landed, he said that you can get your cell phones and call your families. And that made me know roughly that it was serious and let them know that you're okay. And of course, my humorous mind said, "Why wouldn't I be okay?" Nobody's cell phone would work. I said, nobody's cell phone would work. Out of 85, 900 cell phones on the plane, nobody's would work. Finally, one cell phone rang. It was mine. And it was Carly saying, "Daddy, where y'all at?" And here again with my humorous, I say, "Grown folk don't have to report to chaps." And this is when it kind of starts setting in. She said, "Daddy, don't play with all that's going on over here. I need to know where y'all at." I said, "Well, we're in Canada." They pulled the plane out of the air early in the morning, Robert Pope, and sent us to a place called Halifax, Nova Scotia, Canada. And until that day, Charles, I didn't even know that there was a real place called Halifax. I thought Halifax was a place that we used to tell the kids when we were growing up, "Go to Halifax." That was our way of telling them to go to hell without. I'm sorry y'all didn't grow up white with that. They pulled 43 planes out of the air to go to Halifax, Nova Scotia. And so I'm comfortable. I said, "Well, you know, we were plane number 42. They pulled 43 out. And they serviced the planes as they got to them. 1, 2, 3, 10, 15, 42. When they got to us, all the hotels were taken up. And they told me they're going to take us to a military base. I said, "Well, they got barracks." When we got to them, they had being number 42. They had given up all the rooms where the soldiers stayed. So they carried us to a gymnasium. When we got there, there were 500 of us in a gymnasium, kind of like this one where we ain't supposed to be in. thought I dropped that little hint. And they had a cart, pallet, cart, pallet, cart, pallet. Tuesday morning. And we stayed there. Georgia on the cart, I'm on the pallet. Along with 498 other people. But that's when we began to appreciate what was really happening, because we could see it on the news that there was an attack on America. 9-1-1. I just want to kind of share that part of the story. I don't know where you were, but that's where we were. But we made the best out of it. Being there, there was a German lady who taken a liking to our company. She kept Georgia busy, and I was grateful for that, because that kept her from getting on my nerves. She said, Georgia, you go sightseeing with me. You know, I said, please go sightseeing. And they did. But everybody knew that there were families who were destroyed. Even people who were not in the towers, you know, firemen and other folk who tried to save other people's lives, lost their lives. A friend of mine named Keith Fullerton, who lives in St. Louis now, he texts his minister's friend every Sunday morning. This morning he says, we have all had the equivalent of a 9-1-1 tragedy in our lives at one time or another. He says, but Jesus Christ is the one who picks up the pieces and puts us back together again. Keith says, even with rumors of terrorist threats like there are today, we are confident to know that the God who keeps us does not sleep, nor does he slumber. We are confident to know that the God who keeps us, get ready to put your hands together, because it said he does not sleep. Y'all are there, he does not sleep. The God who keeps us does not sleep, nor does he slumber. Oh, God, oh, my God. Y'all ain't got it, but God keeps us. Miracle said, I agree with it, that the God who keeps us, he never sleeps. He didn't even take a nap. Hallelujah. 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 And so America, we are a blessed country.
My country, tears.